નમસ્કાર મિત્રો, હું ઋષિ પાઠક, નેચર ક્લબ સુરત, કો એક્ઝિક્યુટિવ વિથ પાયથન અને વાઇલ્ડલાઇફ એન્ડ નેચર વેલફેર ટ્રસ્ટ તરફથી આપ સૌનું હાર્દિક સ્વાગત કરું છું. મિત્રો, જેમ આપણે છેલ્લા 17-18 દિવસથી જોઈ રહ્યા છીએ અને આપણી જર્ની આજે એક બે દિવસ કરતાં કરતાં 19મા દિવસે પહોંચી ગઈ છે. વાઇલ્ડલાઇફ વેબિનારની જે આપણી સિરીઝ જે છે એ આજે 19મા દિવસે પહોંચી ગઈ છે. એક બહુ જ અદભુત વસ્તુ છે કે આપ સૌનો ખૂબ જ સરસ પ્રતિસાદ મળ્યો અને એનાથી જ અમને અલગ જુસ્સો અને અલગ જોશ મળ્યો. તો અમે આ સિરીઝ આગળ વધારી રહ્યા. મિત્રો, જેમ આપણે ગઈકાલે રુદ્ર માતા સાથે રેસ્ટની ટેકનિક્સ ને એના વિશે ખૂબ જ સરસ માહિતી લીધી અને બેઝિક ગાઈડલાઇન્સ એને આપણી સાથે શેર કરી, તો આજે આપણી વચ્ચે છે સહ્યાદ્રી નિસર્ગ મિત્રમાંથી અભિષેક સિંહ, જે પેંગોલિન ઉપર ખૂબ જ સરસ કામગીરી કરી રહ્યા છે અને પેંગોલિન કન્ઝર્વેશન પર ખૂબ જ એગ્રેસિવલી વર્ક કરે છે. પેંગોલિન એટલે કે કીરી ખાવ, જે આપણે મેસેજમાં મેન્શન કર્યું હતું કે વાઇલ્ડલાઇફ ક્રાઇમ માટે મોસ્ટ ટ્રાફિક એનિમલ છે અને થ્રેટન એટલે બહુ જ એન્ડેન્જર્ડ સ્પીસીમેન છે. તો એના ઉપર ખૂબ જ સરસ કામ કરી રહ્યા છે. તો આપણે એમનો વધુ સમય ના બગાડતા એમને રિક્વેસ્ટ કરીશું કે સેશનની શરૂઆત કરે. અભિષેકભાઈ, પ્લીઝ ટેક અ ચાર્ટ.
ગુડ ઇવનિંગ એવરીવન. હિન્દી યા ઇંગ્લિશ ચલેગા?
યસ, હિન્દી એન્ડ ઇંગ્લિશ.
હેલો ઋષિ.
યસ, હિન્દી ઇઝ ગુડ.
હેલો
હેલો.
ગુડ ઇવનિંગ એવરીવન. Here I am today for the talk on conservation of Indian pangolin through community participations. And I work with the Sahyadri Nisarg Mitra, an organization which is based in Chiplun, in Ratnagiri district, Maharashtra, India. First of all, any conservation efforts, if we required to do any conservations of the species or anything, so we required like community participation for that conservations. Without community help and supports, it is not possible to conserve the species in wild or anyhow in any way. So let's start to know about the Indian pangolin. What are the Indian pangolins and other pangolins are found in India, and what are their basic ecology and life parameters and distribution ranges, little bit in detail. So total pangolin species of the world, there are total 8 extant species of the pangolin found across the globe, from which 4 species are found in Asia, in which it is consists like Indian pangolin. Scientific name is like Manis crassica audata, which is an endangered species. Then it comes to Philippine pangolin, Manis curiosis, which is near threatened. Then Sunda pangolin, which is a Manis javanica, it is also an endangered species. And then Chinese pangolin, Manis pentadactyla, which is a critical endangered species. Then the 4 other species also found of the pangolin in the continent, in Africa continent. It's like cap pangolin, which is vulnerable. Then it's come to white-billed pangolin. It is also vulnerable, and the long-tailed pangolin also vulnerable. The giant, the biggest of all the pangolin is the giant ground pangolin. Of the Africa, which is also vulnerable. So, Indian pangolin, first of all, we will let us know about something little bit about the Indian pangolin. Okay, so first of all, in India, there are 2 species of pangolins found. One is Indian pangolin and second is Chinese pangolin. So Indian pangolin is found throughout the Indian subcontinent except Himalayan region and the northeast, some part of the northeast India. Even Chinese pangolin are only very limited to the northeast India. So Chinese pangolin are just found in the northeast part of the northeast India, like that seven sister state of the nation. Okay, Indian pangolins are like they are
they are in length, they are like huge, like 45 to 75 centimeter, and their weight are like around to 10 to 16 kg. Even this species, Indian pangolin, is also found in Pakistan, Sri Lanka country, and then Sri Lanka country, Pakistan, and it Nepal also. And it was believed that previously in history, that pangolin was found in Bangladesh too. But in 2014, when the survey was done, it was found ki there is no presence of the Indian pangolin in Bangladesh. So, the IUCN people have decided that this species has regional extinct from the Bangladesh. This species have 11 to 13 rows overlapping rows of scales on their bodies, which covered their whole body from head to tail. So these scales helps them to protect from the predator and many other threats. Okay. So the whole body is covered with the keratin scales. Second is the species is too much still the species whole behavior is not known, their behavior and ecology, but it is believed that pangolins are the nocturnal species. Yes, they are shy and elusive species. They have powerful claws, sharp and powerful claws, through which they most of what they do, they dig the anthills and termite mound for their feeding purpose. Species don't have the teeth. They have long sticky tongues, which helps to catch the prey. And the tongues size are around 1 to 1.5 feet. Species have ear flap and nose flap, which helps when they dig the termite mounds and they prey on them, on termite or the or ant species. So during that time, this nose flap and ear flap helps that ant or termite species to get inside through the nose or the ear or into the pangolin. Burrow, the nest, species live inside the burrow. So that powerful claw, as I mentioned in the previous slide, is also used to dig the burrows to make the nest, resting nest or the living burrows, as well as helps to dig for the feeding burrows also. Burrow size is minimum 4 to 5 meters in length, and the diameter, the opening diameter of the burrow is approximately 25 to 35 centimeter in the size. The burrows mostly the species burrow mostly found on the lowland or on the slope at the elevations, most of burrows are found under the rocks. And there are few burrows, if we will observe in wild, then it will be found under the tree, under the scrub areas. And sometimes the burrows were also observed in the dry streamlet of the pangolin. It is believed pangolin has a poor eyesight, okay, but they have a strong smell sense, and it plays very important role in the ecosystem, controlling the insect in the environment or in the ecosystems. It is one of the natural pesticides. It works as in one of the natural pesticides. In approximately 70 to 80 millions of insects it consumes annually, and which consists of ants and termite. Okay, And recently we had done the SCAT analysis of this species, and we had found these 7 species mentioned in the slides, like Camponotus angusticollis, Camponotus compressus, Polyrachis manellus, Caribara affinis, Camponotus angusticollis again, Camponotus parius, and Ossifila smaragdina, which is an ant weaver ant. Okay, so on this basically the pangolin, these ant species are the preference for the pangolin in the wild. And in this book, it was published recently. It was published in these books. Our findings are published in this book. The sample was collected from the Maharashtra in Konkan region of northern Western Ghat, and we had done that SCAT analysis for to know about the prey preference of the species, which is what is the feeding ecology of the species. Pangolin is a Malayan word. Okay. If you observe the image, it has rolled down like a ball. Okay. So this word pangolin, it is a from Malayan word, and it means like rolled down as a ball. So when there is a threat, whenever there is a threat, so species roll down and pretend like a ball or a stone nearby the habitat, and these protective scales are too hard that any of the predator can't break it from their jaws or their claws. Even many believe like bullet also not impact on such scales. The second defense mechanism in the pangolin species is like they release noxious chemical smells from a gland near to their anus. Okay, the female gives actually the main reason is this also, that this species give one or a two pups annually. Okay, so the survival chance is already decreased of this species. So the gestation period of the pangolin is like 65 to 70 days. When a newborn baby born at during that time, there is no scales on the body. Okay, so what happens, there are only hairs on that species on the body of the pangolin pups. Slowly when it grows, species grown ups into the adult, so slowly that hairs infused with each other and become a scales and act as an armor. Baby feed at least 3 months on the milk of the mother. And yes, pangolins may we can observe the parental care, and in which only mother take care of the babies. Major to the species. The major threat is like I think from on my experience, it is like a low level of awareness within the community. And many of the blind following of the tradition and ancient things regarding to the species. Okay, so like in 1990, IUCN announced the decline in population of pangolin species, due to the illegal demand in the international market for the delicacy of their meats, and the scales were used in the traditional Chinese medicine. In some traditional medicine, it was believed that pangolin's soup or pangolin's fetus blood helps in the aphrodisiac to increase the sexual stamina in people, as well as it was believed like the fetus of pangolin, if consumed, then the pregnant woman will be the healthy and the baby will be the healthy. there are also so lots of social belief for the hunting. If we go for the northwest, northeast India or the some other part of the region of the India, so it was believed like the species species has social belief in community. Many tribal community people have the social belief for their hunting. They some hunts in one of the tribal I have gone across through the discussion with the tribes in northeast India, and one of the tribe had told me that they only hunt when someone died in their community. So they go into the forest and they hunt this species, and after hunting this species they bring, and that species will be put near to the house of that person. So I asked them ki why it's so. So it was like ki after death the pangolin will serve that person souls. So there are lots of social belief also in the community. Then it comes on the poaching and hunting for the illegal demands. Then awareness and education within the community is in very very low level, which is the major threat also, which is also the major threat for the species decline, species population decline in wild. As I said, that scale is just nothing, just a hair of the pangolin species, which is infused. And these scales are made up of a keratin protein. Okay, so such protein is available in our body also, like in hairs, in nails. We had also the scales are present from the tip of the head to the end portion of the tail, as well as the species on the both limb have the scales covered. That total body weight of the species, it consists like 20% of the body weight is like of the scales. Okay, so it is believed that a single pangolin have 1.5 to 2 kgs of the scales. Conservation efforts. So we are working on few objectives, like in situ conservation of Indian pangolin through local participation in the Konkan region. So for that, what happens is we need to sensitize and aware the community about the species and their ecologically importance in the ecosystem. Why they are very important for and why people need to be conserved the species. Second of that, we are observing the current status of the Indian pangolin in the region. It is very necessary to streamline the conservation efforts, future conservation efforts of the species. Ecology and behavioral patterns of Indian pangolin is also very important factor for the conservation of the species. So we are doing this from the camera trapping method, which is very easy and it is very viable to do such things in wild, because as I said in the previously that species are very shy and elusive, as well as nocturnal. So it is very difficult to find them in the wild during daytime or even in the night time also. So for that, camera trapping is very best method for such elusive species. Second is like we are trying to understand the human perspective, social and religious belief of the community towards the species. Some have the religious belief of the species for the conservation aspects, and as well as we are using the traditional knowledge of tribal peoples. Like tribal peoples have their traditional knowledge from ancient time about the species ecology. So we use this knowledge to track the species in wild and deploy the camera trap according to that. Second awareness is like sometimes we go for radios and digital way of the awareness to educate or sensitize the people. A great effort made by the Mr. Bhav Kadhdare, who is the IUCN pangolin specialist group member, and he had done a great inputs in the education system. He had written a story on the pangolin, and he posed to the education system that this story should be placed into the primary curriculum of the education of the students, which helps to create a mass awareness within the students. And present students, we believe that present students are the future, could be the future conservationist in the future. Now, very important is that does COVID-19, the present COVID-19 disease of the coronavirus, is like spread from pangolin or what? Like, there are many news, many articles that the pangolin is the host of the species, as well as the present COVID-19 disease was transmitted from the pangolin consumption, due to the pangolin consumption, or the pangolins in the wet market of Wuhan city. But then scientists starting of the 2020 had found one Malayan pangolin which was seized by the frontline department of the nation of Singapore nation, and it was like when this Malayan pangolin was found, so scientists had taken the samples for the to study the coronavirus is present or not present in the species and what are the results. So the study was found that yes, pangolin is the host of the coronavirus, okay, and the and it was named like pangolin coronavirus 2020. Then for understanding that this coronavirus 2020, pangolin coronavirus 2020, is identical to the present COVID-19, SARS-CoV-19. So for that, a genetical study was done, and it was found that 90.23% is pangolin COVID-2020 is 90.23% identical to the present COVID-19 viruses. But at the same time, the sample from the bat also was extracted, and it was found that the gene BatCoV RATG13 is totally identical, is 96.12% identical to the present COVID-19. But yet it was not confirmed that what is the host of the present coronavirus through which COVID-19 was like intermediate host. What is the intermediate host of the present coronavirus which had caused the COVID-19 disease across the globe, which become now a pandemic situation in all over the countries and as well as in our nation also. Thank you guys. There is a one small video which I am going to show you people, so please be there. It is our conservation efforts, how we had started our conservation effort for the pangolin conservation. Just wait for it. हेलो
अभिषेक द वीडियो इज नॉट शोइंग ऑन द स्क्रीन एक्चुअली
1992 सह्याद्री निसर्ग
ऋषि
यस
ये कैन यू हेल्प मी टू डिस्प्ले दिस वीडियो
यस जस्ट डिड एज वी डिड फॉर आवर प्रेजेंटेशन
सॉरी आई कांट हियर यू योर वॉइस इज
हेलो हेलो नाउ इट्स ऑडिबल हेलो
हेलो
हाँ तो अपने प्रेजेंटेशन को शेयर किया था उसी हिसाब से वो वीडियो शेयर कर दीजिए
आई एम नॉट हियरिंग यू
हेलो
आर यू गेटिंग माय वॉइस
यस यस आई गेटिंग योर वॉइस हेलो हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हेलो यस
हेलो
हेलो हेलो यस
हाँ नाउ कैन यू हियर मी
यस आई कैन हियर यू
Okay, so could you help me how to this video I can show?
Yeah, so background mein video open kar lijiye aur jaise humne share screen karke application window mein share kiya tha, waise hi aap share kar dijiye wo video.
Main aise hi share kar du?
Nahi, jaise wo humne PPT share kiya tha, waise hi video share kar lijiye.
Okay, okay, okay. Just wait for. Okay, Rishi.
Yes. Yes.
Can you see the videos?
No, I can see your screen actually. You are sharing your current screen. So just go in the video and play it.
I video can start.
Video में चले जाओ video play कर दीजिए सिर्फ अब.
मैं video में ही हूँ और video चालू किया हो. आपको video दिख रहा है क्या?
नहीं video नहीं दिख रहा है अभी.
Hello?
नहीं video नहीं दिख रहा है.
Okay. ये पेंगुलिन का logo दिख रहा है क्या मेरे screen पे?
नहीं 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 नहीं.
Yes, there is then some issues.
No problem. Your videos in on मतलब Google Drive में है या ऐसे कहीं जगह पे तो मुझे link share कर दीजिए. I can show that video.
So I can share the link of this.
Google Drive में हो तो Google Drive का link है ऐसा कुछ मेरे साथ share कर दीजिए तो मैं यहाँ से play कर दूँ.
Okay, मैं ना अभी private chat में आपको share करता हूँ link.
Okay, okay.
Mitra, located in Chiplun, Maharashtra.
अभिषेक, नाउ वीडियो इज विजिबल.
हाँ, ये रहा लिंक, मैं आपको शेयर कर रहा हूँ. दिस इज द लिंक आई हैव शेयर्ड यू.
अभिषेक, आई प्ले, मैं वीडियो प्ले करता हूँ, तब तक आप क्वेश्चन के आंसर कर लेते हैं तब तक.
तो ये अभी इनका तो ये आया है, लेकिन मैं यहाँ पे लाइव कमेंट पे जा रहा हूँ, लेकिन वो रिप्लाई नहीं हो रहा है. क्यों? मुझे रिप्लाई के लिए कोई ऑप्शन नहीं दिख रहा है.
आप बोल के रिप्लाई कर दीजिए ताकि सब लोग भी सुन सके.
लाइक ये वसीम खान खिलची ने पूछा है कि आर पैंगोलिन डेंजरस टू मैन, तो दे कैन हियर मी?
यस, दे कैन हियर यू, एवरीबॉडी कैन हियर यू, जस्ट गो थ्रू विद द क्वेश्चंस एंड वेटिंग देयर आंसर्स.
हेलो,
यस, सब सुन सकते हैं, आप आंसर दीजिए.
तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द पैंगोलिन्स आर नॉट डेंजरस टू द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स बिकॉज दे डोंट यूज देयर क्लॉज टू लाइक हर्ट अस बिकॉज व्हेन दे सी द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स दे जस्ट बिकम लाइक अ बॉल लाइक स्ट्रक्चर ड्यू टू देयर शाय बिहेवियर दे आर नॉट डेंजरस फॉर अस बट वी ह्यूमंस आर too much dangerous for them because of these defensive mechanisms rolling down into the ball has made us a threat for them because when they see us and become a ball So what human being do is they pick up that that species, and then they take them them to with them, and then what they do they put that live species into the boil water. You just believe that how much painful that death will be of that species. कि एक उबलता हुआ पानी है, एक पूरा खोलता हुआ पानी है, बॉइल्ड वाटर है, उसमें आप पूरा लाइफ, किसी लाइफ को आप पुट अप कर दे रहे हैं. एंड द सेकेंड वे ऑफ हंटिंग दिस स्पीशीज की वो लोग लाते हैं और जिंदा आग में डाल देते हैं इस स्पीशीज को. तो वी आर डेंजरस फॉर देम, पैंगोलिन्स आर नॉट डेंजरस फॉर अस. थैंक यू. What is the population of pangolin? So, brother Anjana Jala, sorry, I have called you brother. Dear, that pangolin population is still not estimated across the nation, and it is very tough to estimate the pangolin population in the nation because the scientific methodology what we are using to estimate the population, it is like a old method. It needs like a new standard operating procedures for finding out the pangolin population. Are pangolin scale used to make anything? Yes, pangolin scales are used to made a lots of things. Like pangolin's scales are used to make jewelries, then the wallets, purse, luxurious, all the luxurious material was used to the to make the pangolins to make the things with from the pangolin scales. Like I have said in the recent study, Chinese people are started to make the bulletproof jackets from these scales. Approx how many ants does a pangolin eat? It was assumed like 20,000 per day, and approximately 70 to 80 millions of insect annually pangolin have. Where we can find most of the pangolins? Okay. So most of the pangolins are found all over in all the habitats. It presents in each and every habitats of the nations. Wherever you can go in the jungles, you can find out. But as I said, the species has a very like shy and elusive behavior, due to which it is very difficult to sight the pangolin in wild. If you are very lucky, then you can find it anywhere in the across the nation. Are most of the pangolin extinct? I have said in the starting of the presentations that pangolins are still not extinct. Okay, so yes, there are the species of pangolin which are in the endangered list as well as in the critical endangered list, and still every day, every single day, like 13 millions or 14 millions pangolin were killed every day, just to provide the international demands, just to fulfill the international demand for the scales and the meat purpose. Why pangolin carry their babies on their back? Okay, this is very good question. Why pangolin carry their babies on their back? Okay, so it is a parental care, like our mothers or our parents take us in their hands, they take us in their lap or hand, and anywhere they can go. In the same way, the pangolin mother is also have, pangolin species have the parental care. So till 3 months, till when the species can't walk properly, and it required to protect from the predators and all the things, for that purpose pangolin mother carries the babies on their back. Thank you.
Video is ready now, we can show that video, so I'll link that video.
Rishi, I have one problem that I can't hear your voice. So
hello,
I can send you. You can send me a message. Whatever you have to say.
Hello. काकड़ी है आधे से ज्यादा ही हो, आधा किलो से ज्यादा नहीं हो, पतला वाला दे, पतला वाला सब ऐसे ही आंटी, मोटा मोटा ही आया है
working incessantly at the grassroots level through community conservation. Knowing the importance of traditional wisdom, he has persuaded many locals towards conservation. Some local tribes are actively involved in poaching and smuggling of wild animals. If we provide them with better alternatives of livelihood, this valuable treasure of traditional wisdom about natural history can be used for the purpose of conservation. Livelihood through nature conservation.
Along with extensive fieldwork, the trap camera gives an insight into the unknown world of animals. Ongoing sightings in the wild are becoming rare. One of the major findings of the project is locating active burrows of the pangolin.
these active burrows are being protected with the help of knuckles. SLM has raised awareness across the region with consistent support extended by the Forest Department. The involvement of the future generation in the process strengthens the effort. School children are a potential source to percolate the awareness at the ground level. SLM has found many ingenious ways to nurture the love towards nature and instill a sense of responsibility among local people. The journey from gathering mere evidence to a growing number of rescue calls substantiates the elevated awareness in society. In the year 2018-2019, 12 pangolins were rescued by the local community in collaboration with the Forest Department. This scenario is changing slowly. It's time to multiply such efforts on a global scale. The web of life is intricate, and the loss of any thread hampers the entire life cycle.
Yeah.
We need to extend this effort further to fight against the plight of the pangolin. There is still a glimmer of hope. Come, let's strive together to bring these animals back from the brink of extinction.
वॉइस नहीं आ रही है एकदम.
आई विल शेयर अ लिंक विद यू.
हेलो हेलो
हेलो
हेलो हेलो वॉइस आ रही है मेरी क्योंकि आपकी नहीं आ रही है मुझे.
जस्ट वेट अ मोमेंट. हेलो
So from last 3 years we are on the field working for the conservation of the species in the northern Western Ghat, as well as I am working in the northeast India also. We in the collaboration for the Chinese pangolin conservations. Okay, we have found that
खाली एक
तो फ्रॉम लास्ट थ्री इयर्स लाइक इट वाज वी आर ट्राइंग टू फाइंड द स्पीशीज इन लाइक वाइल्ड बट इट वाज लाइक too much of tough like many of times we are on the field during the night session also to observe near the burrow we observe tried even many of times we have tried the technology on the field to track the species so but it is very difficult to observe one wild species one pangolin in wild and if you are lucky to you can go for it like when I was in northeast India for the for Chinese pangolin field study purpose so during that time we have gone through with many peoples have communicate with many local peoples and it was like believed that they are doing very well a conservation also with the hunting it is not they have their own community reserved forest and they don't hunt over there and they hunt in the like which are the part which is not a community reserved which are the like local part of the forest they hunt from there and we have observed many of things of the species through our video through our camera trapping like sometimes I have observed the species rolling into the forest floor I had tried to figure out why the species are doing like this way why these are doing like rolling on the forest floor so then I thought it might be like some of the host pests or the things there are the pests on the forest floor which jump on the bodies of the species so to remove for that thing they do many of times they most of time I had observed them walking on the they use their front leg very less time and they don't put a lots of weight on their front leg okay so they little bit forelimb will be above from the ground level now we are trying to understand the human perspective view like why like pangolin how do people are looking for the pangolin like does they have any social belief or cultural belief as I had said you one story about that northeast that social belief of that tribal community in the same way like there are many of the social beliefs which are not documented and we have found that this tribal people or the local forest people have a great knowledge about the forest floor because they had roamed this forest floor there from their ancient times their fathers their forefathers had done a lot of things and lot of observation they have about the species so at that time they have more knowledge about the ecology of the species also so it is very good going and there are many things you can find if you can visit on Sahyadri Nisarg Mitra website so there you can find story books pictorial story books which is made for the students and the people who loves to read the story book so you can have that access from our website it is very free of cost there is no cost for that the PDF is in two languages in English and as well as in Marathi local language of the Maharashtra so whatever the languages you want to prefer you can go for it even we are trying more things like a religious based things also to involve for the conservation of this species like if we have to conserve any species so if it will get a religious aspect of the community then it is little bit easy for the conservation Like recently we had tried an experimental model in Western Ghats that on the World Pangolin Day celebration, it was like the villagers have believed that pangolin is God and pangolin protect their farms. Pangolins help their farm to protect their farm, their forest flows from the ants, termites and other insectivores. So, and there is a one full Devi temple near the village where all the villagers where all the villagers visit to worship the Kul Devi. So that people having discussing with that people, slowly they believed that pangolin helps them a lot in the maintaining the ecosystem and nearby ecosystem. They believed that Wagzai goddess Wagzai of that villages helped given a pangolin species to them to protect them from the insect and all the things. And according to they used to pray a species like a worship as a god. They first worship that Wagzai goddess, and then later on they worship the model of pangolin in front of the Wagzai goddess. They put that model and then they start worshipping them. After then worshipping that, they took that pangolin models into a pangolin, and they in a traditional form they dance and they have lots of fun in a traditional and cultural form. So this is also one of the great aspects, that a whole village pray a species as an god. So this help conservation on a ground by the community, local community. As of our education and sensitization methodology, which we have used, like modern technology, as well as banners, pamphlets, and a lot of things we had used to impact, to aware and educate the community, it results very good. Like last year in 2019, local community come front and had rescued like around approximately 15 pangolins. And this at the starting of this year, in the February month, we have rescued, like the community, local community had came forward and informed the police department that there are few poachers or the few people who are taking a live pangolin with them for the sale. And just because of the local enthusiasm towards the species, the police had acted rapidly and caught that people on the highway, and they have seized the two live sub-adult pangolin. So these are the things, like now people are a little bit knowing about the species and their ecological importance, as well as now they are joining it with their religious customs and traditional practices. So somewhere it is a positive hope for the conservation of the species in the nation. Thank you guys for being here. It was a very wonderful time with you people.
Thank you so much. Hello, ma'am. Now I'm audible.
Hello.
Since 1992,
Sayadri Nisargamitra, located in Chiplun, Maharashtra, has been taking firm steps in wildlife conservation. Recently, SNM took the initiative for the conservation of the pangolin, the most trafficked animal in the world. The strange thing is, very few people are aware of the plight of this animal. High demand for its scales, which are believed to have aphrodisiac medicinal properties, has pushed this animal on the brink of extinction. There is also a demand for its meat, as it is considered a delicacy in many countries. Among eight extant species of the pangolin, the Indian pangolin is found throughout the Indian subcontinent. There is a strict legal framework to protect this animal. The pangolin is categorized under the endangered category as per the IUCN Red List. The Indian judiciary imparts the highest degree of protection to the pangolin, similar to the tiger. Despite all the protection, the roots of illegal trade are spread across India too. There is an illegal racket of poachers who are secretly active in many areas of high potential. Poaching and hunting have been the major pressures for the decline of the species, along with some other issues like loss of habitat due to wood logging and development on a rampant scale. There is still a lack of awareness among people, which exacerbates the situation. The ground realities and statistics say that it's high time to act. Addressing the need of the hour, SNM initiated the project Save Pangolin in Ratnagiri district. Bhau Katdare is working incessantly at the grassroots level through community conservation. Knowing the importance of traditional wisdom, he has persuaded many locals towards conservation. Some local tribes are actively involved in poaching and smuggling of wild animals. If we provide them with better alternatives of livelihood, this valuable treasure of traditional wisdom about natural history can be used for the purpose of conservation. Livelihood through nature conservation has been the prime motto so far. Understanding the ecology of the species is always the first and foremost important step in any conservation project. Along with extensive field work, the trap camera gives an insight into the unknown world of animals. Pangolin sightings in the wild are becoming rare. One of the major findings of the project is locating active burrows of the pangolin. These active burrows are being protected with the help of locals. SNM has raised awareness across the region with consistent support extended by the Forest Department. The involvement of the future generation in the process strengthens the effort. school children are a potential source to percolate the awareness at the ground level. SNM has found many ingenious ways to nurture the love towards nature and instill a sense of responsibility among local people. The journey from gathering mere evidence to a roaring number of rescue calls substantiates the elevated awareness in society. In the year 2018-2019, 12 pangolins were rescued by the local community in collaboration with the Forest Department. The scenario is changing slowly. It's time to multiply such efforts on a global scale. The web of life is intricate, and the loss of any thread hampers the entire life cycle. We need to extend this effort further to fight against the plight of the pangolin. There is still a glimmer of hope. Come, let's strive together to bring these animals back from the brink of extinction.
Hello. Thank you so much for joining us and considering our request. We are end up here. Thank you so much, viewers, for joining us.